I enjoyed all that Spice Girls, you know, thing. Thought it was, you know, great.
I thought they were awesome.
It was like magical. It was lightning in a bottle.
This was a dessert made in heaven.
For me, the music industry around that time was lacking strong female roles. You had artists like Annie Lennox, really successful, strong, independent woman. But when it came to sort of the younger end of the market, there was nobody like that around. Boy bands were dictating. But the video had to encapsulate everything that Spice Girls wanted it to say about them. You've got that brilliant staircase going up where the girls perform, again, in outfits that are true to them. And I think it was quite groundbreaking. If you notice, it's shot on one camera. And it's a party and they're causing havoc as ever. And I think it really did sum up the feeling at the moment of being rebels, being our gang. We don't care what anybody thinks about us. Be true to ourselves, but look after your mates. For the girls to appear on Top of the Pops, it was crucial. TV absolutely drove this track.
I was the first person to introduce the Spice Girls on Top of the Pops. How about that?
We did a promo trip to Japan and we had to perform Top of the Pops out there because the single had gone straight in at number 3. I had cutaways of the Top of the Pops sign that literally I was carrying under my arm, stuck them on this temple. We did get permission, by the way, before anyone gets upset. And there they were, performing Wannabe for the very first time on Top of the Pops.
By the time they came back, Wannabe had gone to number 1. They were on Top of the Pops that week. I had this idea and I said, well, we're going to give you your own nicknames and we're going to have Top of the Pops magazine's names for you. Do you want to be Scouse Spice? Do you want to be Saucy Spice, which was going to be Jerry for a while?
If you think of Melanie C, we know Melanie C as an incredible artist. We'll also always know her as Sporty. Melanie B always was going to wear the leopard print because she loved it.
Victoria, Posh Spice. Jerry, Ginger Spice. And Emma, Baby Spice.
It wasn't like there was a stylist in the background sort of contriving it and putting it all together. It was far more organic than that.
It just caught on like no one could ever imagine, you know.
They just all burst in my office and like sat on my desk, sat all over, started like going through my record collection. What's this? What's this? What's this?
All those rumours you've heard about the Spice Girls as early days are probably true. And they weren't going to take any rubbish from any men, that was for sure.
I get a call, said, look, we've got a session going on in Olympic Studios over in Barnes. I'd love you to go over there. It's a band called the Spice Girls, one of our big new signings. They want a bit of harmonica on the end of a track. They wanted something like a Karma Chameleon type feel. And here it goes. There's a little snippet from what was done. 3 harmonicas into one. Or something like that. And then the next thing is the record takes off. Boom. Number one UK. Boom. It became number one all over the world.
The chemistry of those 5 women. And when they broke through, it really felt important to little girls who were growing up, you know? The pop industry had, you know, said, well, young girls want to just see boys that they can fancy, and we don't. We want women to represent us.
I think it was Baby, yeah.
They just went stratospheric.
The hits, the records, the touring, the merchandise, everything changed. They changed everything.
I'm very happy and we all lived happily ever after. Bless the Spices. If you wanna be my lover.